So what are the implications of today's by-election results for West Bengal and for national politics? Let's get straight into the debate now. Let me start with a minister in the Union Council of Ministers as well as Trinamool Congress leader Dinesh Trivedi. The smile on your face says it all, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's the reflection of the people's smile on my face.
You're gloating, basically.
Not really, because, you know, at the end of the day, it's really people who wanted liberation, who wanted peace, who wanted governance.
Talking like a Maoist.
Who wanted liberation. He's talking like a Maoist.
Liberation.
So, you see, this is what happens with the electronic media, that you want to make a joke of serious things, where you don't understand what things are.
So what's now, the serious message? Okay, what's the serious message emerging from this?
The serious message is loud and clear. I mean, those people who live in West Bengal, neither you live nor he lives. You ask an ordinary farmer, they day in and day out, they are tortured, they are beaten up, they are murdered. What are we asking? That we want peace? Just lay off. Let them live their lives.
But are you overstating the import of these results? Because after all, if you look at changes, the CPM held only two seats of the seats that went to polls, and they've not managed to retain those. The Forward Bloc has picked up one. So are you overstating the import?
I'm just calm and quiet. As you are asking, if you see right from the panchayat elections earlier held, then we had Nandigram by-election, then we had Bishnupur by-election, where for last 33 years, nobody won but the CPM and the left. We got elected there by a margin of over 30,000 votes. So this is the volumes. Then we have the Lok Sabha election. Then we had elections into local bodies. You even go to universities, small school elections. Everywhere it is more than a wave. And it is, at the end of the day, the reflection of the people.
Okay.
Who are absolutely fed up with the torture.
Torture, strong word again. Sankarshan Thakur, not many people from the left are speaking today. That's a sign also of something. Buddhadev Bhattacharjee has not reacted so far either publicly. What do you see this in terms of its implication for Bengal? What are we saying? Because this is also a week in which Buddha Babu completed 10 years as chief minister, ironically.
Yes. No, I think this is confirmation of a turned tide, Barkha. You know, this is, well, another layer in the CPM's coffin. And I think from now on till the next elections, assembly elections, it's going to be a painfully slow death for the party, I'm afraid, you know. Because I think the sense I get is that the CPM has got into a very, very defensive, almost paralyzed state of mind in West Bengal in terms of governance, in terms of political rhetoric, in terms of...
Is it the chief minister himself? Is it a crisis of leadership? Is it a crisis of ideology?
Well, I think both. I think both. And I think at some very critical levels, the chief minister is not in sync with the central party. And those things, the party has dug its head in the ground ostrich-like, is refusing to confront the realities that it must face sometime. But I'm afraid, you know, in terms of West Bengal, they've already lost it, I dare say, although there's more than a year to go for the elections. But I think the mood in West Bengal is pretty much set, because this is not a single reverse that the CPM has faced. It's the end of a series of reverses at various levels of elections.
From starting with the local elections. Absolutely. Let's get a view from Kolkata now. Professor Sarkar, how does it look like to the people of Kolkata? There was a time not so long ago, pre-Nandigram, when Buddhadev Bhattacharjee was quite the darling, in a sense, of the middle class in Bengal. What do you think turned the tide? Because Mamata Banerjee, for example, used to be resented for her hartals, for what some called her shrill politics. What do you think shifted the perception of middle class Bengal?
Yeah, that's a very good question. You see, in 2006... CPM came with a lot of mandate, you know, with a, you know, lot of seats and all that. But after that, what happened was, I think a creamy layer was created within the party whose aspirations had changed. So that led to a change in ideology within the party. they were looking for things which were different. I mean, industrialization is, you know, it's not a sin to go for industrialization, but the way it was done, or at least attempted to be done, people didn't like it. At least, you know, the poor people didn't like it, the farmers didn't like it.